As we begin today, I'm going to let you in on a little secret that I've discovered, and I kind of suspect you've discovered this secret too, and that is narcissists are terribly insecure people. Now, that's not a huge newsflash, is it? When you've been around a narcissist long enough, you realize that they have huge ego needs. They're constantly looking for someone or multiple someones to say, you know, there's something unique about you. There's something special about you. And narcissists hunger for that. And the fact that they hunger for that higher position, that superior position so strongly implies that there's some sort of compensation going on there. What's that all about? You see, narcissists, it's like they have this big, huge ego bucket, and they're wanting you and anyone else to come along and fill up their ego bucket. They're like a junkie who's looking for their next fix or their next next high so that they can, okay, calm down and be okay with themselves. Narcissists look for what we refer to as narcissistic supply. Because they have that deep sense of insecurity and they've got that fix, that hunger, that craving for someone to come along and fill them and make them feel better about themselves and superior, then they're going to look to you to see if they can think, are you someone that can fill my needs? Are you going to be someone that can fill my supplies? So what I want to do today is I want to talk to you about 8 different cues that narcissists can watch for as they're seeking their narcissistic supply. Now, when I go through these cues with you, you're going to think, well, most of these sound pretty good to me. And the point is, right. They'll pick up on some of the better characteristics that you have in your personality, and they'll try to use them against you. So the more you're aware of this, then the more you can stay out of their clutches. So that's where we're going with this. Now, what is it that a narcissist looks for? What cues do they look for that could imply that you would fill their supply? Well, the first thing they watch for is that you like companionship. And you think, well, that's a good thing. And so what narcissists can do, particularly as they're getting to know you or they're they've got something in their mind that they want to accomplish, they'll be friendly to you at times. And they can think, okay, you want companionship. You're the kind of individual that enjoys being around people. Yeah, we can work on that. And then eventually what they'll do is they'll get to know you and they'll do nice things for you. But every nice thing that they do kind of goes onto their scorecard. And then later on, they're thinking, you owe me. Because you see, I'm the best thing that happened to you, and I'm somebody that knows you more than anybody else does, or I'm in your business now, like other individuals don't. So why don't you just go ahead and do things the way I want, because you don't want me to abandon you now, do you? And so, interestingly, they're setting you up as they give you a certain form of companionship, because down the road, they're going to use that as a vehicle towards keeping you inside their fold. Now, a second cue that they pick up on from you that implies that you could become their supply is that they know that you want to keep a good public image. Now, who doesn't want to have a good public image? You know, your reputation is important. And the more the narcissist picks up on that and realizes, you know, you want people to think well of you. And you want to, you know, you're on this organization or you're with this group over here, or you have this reputation here at work that is so heavy as a part of your credibility. Then later on, as they know you much more fully, it's kind of like you wouldn't want these people over here to know about that temper tantrum you threw the other day, did you? Do you? And so they'll hold your negatives against you in such a way where you're beholden to them. Or let's suppose that you said something that might have been critical about someone else. And then it's like, you know, other folks think that you're a really nice person, but I know you differently. And I know that you can think critical thoughts. You're not nearly as nice. And as a result, it's like they've kind of got a grip on you now because they know that your reputation is important. So they play off of that. And in the meantime, it allows them to feel like they have a position of power. That's their supply. That's their fix. A third cue that they can pick up on, and that is you can be the kind of person that likes to speak well of other individuals. In other words, you're the kind of person that pays compliments, you like to be an uplifting presence in other people's life. You know, you can say, you know, this person, I really like the way they handled this, or this person over here, they're just such a joy to be around, and I really enjoy their company. And the narcissist is thinking, you know, it's a good that you like to speak well of other individuals, and I want to make sure that you're doing that with kind of an us mentality. Include me on that, will you? And so you might wind up saying things like, well, you know, if the narcissist, for example, has done something improper, you might say something like, well, but he's really a teddy bear on the inside. Or if that other individual has done something and everybody's wondering, you know, what's her issue? It's like, well, she's been under a lot of stress lately, so don't worry about it. She'll get through it. And if you're the kind of person that tries to speak well to the extent that you make excuses on the narcissist's behalf, they're thinking, okay, good. And that's a cue they pick up on. It's like, ooh, I like that characteristic in you. Let's play that up as much as possible. Or a fourth cue that they are looking for from you. And this one can sound a little strange at first, but I think you'll go along with me. And that is, you're willing to argue with them. Now, you might think, why is that a cue that helps them feel, or that lets them know that they can feel superior at my expense? Well, it's because they can argue with you all day long, and it's like, you're willing to play my game, aren't you? Good, because I'll wear you out. And when you argue with them, it's like, ooh, this is such a good inroad for me to show who's the boss around here, or who's the ultimate person that whose opinion needs to be tended to, and it sure isn't you. And so when you're willing to go into that argumentative game, and when you're willing to get into that tit-for-tat kind of communication, and both of you are agitated, they won't quit. And it's like, I like this because when I put you down, it elevates me. You've now become their supply. Or a fifth cue that they pick up on from you that says that you can be exploited. And that is, you can be the kind of person that can be cajoled away from your boundaries. And when we talk about boundaries, we talk about you having a well-conceived notion of who you are and what you want to prioritize and what you believe in. The narcissist can be the kind of person that says, oh, come on, you don't have to do that, or why don't we just do something a little bit different? And so they can take you out of your comfort zone at times. I've had people who've left the narcissist, and it's like, you know, when I was with that person, we drank too heavily, or I wasn't really allowed to be around my family members, and even though I wanted to be around them, it's like it was just too much trouble. They talked me out of it, and so I'd go along just to get along. Or the way we handled money, I didn't like the way that we did that. And, you know, things of that nature. The narcissist is looking for someone that can be cajoled away from their normal way of doing things, because they're hoping that you're not confident enough in your boundaries so that they can step in and they can just say, well, let's just do things my way. They like that. A sixth cue that they pick up on, and that is, if you're a servant and you'd like to be helpful, it's like, okay, good. I can work this. Because you know what? I happen to enjoy being served. And when somebody's helpful, I like to be the one on the receiving end of it. And so these individuals can set themselves up to be on the receiving end of your good nature. It's like you're constantly feeling like, well, I'm just doing them one favor after another, and they ask me to do things and set aside my preferences, and I'll do it. Because the more you like to be kind and friendly, the more they're thinking, I can use this to my advantage. And so they pick up on that from you, and you're thinking, I thought this was a good trait. And it is, until the narcissist shows up. A seventh cue that narcissists pick up on that imply that they can use you for their supply, and this is another one that feels insidious, and that is, you're willing to discuss personal matters. You'll talk about your emotions and your needs. You may disclose some of your hurts and some of your historical experiences that have not gone well. And the narcissist may think, okay, tell me more. Because all the while, they're thinking, there's going to be a day when I need some material that I can use against you to elevate myself. And this is my inroad right here. And so the more you're the individual that's self-disclosing and you get into those personal dimensions, they're looking at that as an opportunity to exploit. Or an eighth cue that they pick up on. and that is you're able to be motivated by duty or obligation. You see, narcissists, they live with a tight agenda. There's a certain way things are supposed to be around here, and I'm the one that writes the agenda. And so if they sense that you're somebody that's an agenda-driven kind of person, it's like, good, we can do this all day long, because I'm just going to keep telling you, well, you should have done this, and here's what your obligation is here. And so in doing this, it's their way of saying, I can stay on the superior side. Now, see, let's go back to that original thought that I gave, that these are individuals who are trying to get their ego bucket filled. They're that addict that's looking for a fix. And they want you to feel beholden to them. And they look for all of these good characteristics in you that implies, okay, you're going to be somebody that's going to do it for me. So let's cover real quickly three things that we can watch for so that you don't get caught up in this exploitive kind of scheming that they have. And the first is you want to stay grounded in your own self-respect. Remember one of the things I mentioned, Dr. C, DRC stands for dignity, respect, and civility. When we have close relations, we don't want it to be anchored in exploitation and how can I use you? We want it to be anchored in those kind of healthy characteristics. And the narcissist who's unable to go that path isn't going to give it to you, but you need to make sure that you anchor your life in self-respect. That's not something they can declare. That's just part of your humanity. Live into it. And then a second thing we want to say is trust your gut. When you realize this narcissist is trying to get me to constantly be over there on their team and trying to make me be somebody that I'm not comfortable with that. Okay, listen to what you're saying and allow yourself to follow through on what your good gut tells you. In other words, we go back to that word boundaries again. Stick with your boundaries. And then a third thing. Remind yourself that even though they want you to fill that ego bucket, they want you to be their supply, it's not your responsibility to prop up the narcissist. That's something that they need to learn to come to terms with within themselves, as opposed to trying to exploit other individuals to fill them up. Okay? So let's just say this. When they look for you to be their narcissistic supply, I'm hoping that you can say, my supply store is closed. I'm not going to fill your ego bucket that's full of leaky holes. You're going to need to go find a different source for your supply. And believe me, they will. Now, I do hope that you get some good insight and awareness with videos such as this. If you've not already done so, I would invite you to go below and hit that subscribe button, and we'll keep more videos coming your way. It could be that by looking at topics like this, it can dredge up some thoughts that you want to discuss with a licensed professional counselor. And all through my career, I've been looking for people to refer folks to. And right now, online counseling is very popular and sometimes very necessary. We've vetted a group that can work with you in an online setting. In this day and age, that's a very positive thing. There's a link below. And if you want to avail yourself of that, I would strongly encourage you to do that. We have our survivingnarcissism.tv and drlescarter.com websites. We have a link down there to our library that has our books, and we have my online videos, lots of stuff down there. I want you to be somebody that has healthiness, but then when you recognize somebody is wanting to exploit your good characteristics, I also want you to be that person that says, I'm committed to good boundaries. I'll take care of myself, knowing that this person has other schemes in mind. I'm not playing that game. I'm going to be somebody that stays in my calm firmness.